Hello, everyone. I'm Pastor Jeff, and welcome to Mosaic Church of the Nazarene. Today, Brother Joe Keller will be sharing with us from the Word of God titled, The Baby Jesus. But first, please join us in some praise and worship music to glorify the Lord.
So Good evening. With Christmas nearly here, I would like to take a pause from the apostles and contemplate the early years of Jesus. Growing up, one of my favorite songs for Christmas became "What Child Is This?" And I have a lot of memories associated to it, because what would happen is my aunt and uncle would come down from Wisconsin with my two favorite cousins, Karin and Dan, and Karin would play the flute, I would play the keyboard or the organ, and my sister would play the alto sax, and we would perform "What Child Is This?" for my parents and for my aunt and uncle. And we look forward to this. All three of us looked forward to this every year. And what made that special is that memory that tied us all together. And also, I love that title too. There's "What Child Is This?" And that's what I want to kind of take a look at here. I kind of want to take a look at the baby Jesus, what he became, because what we do know of Jesus is that he was the firstborn son of Mary and Joseph. Okay, we know that early events in his life were captured in the Bible. Okay, and we know that he had brothers and sisters. Now, how they related to him, we don't know that, but it does talk of brothers and sisters. Past that, we know very little else of his early life. But we know what he became, though. What he was to become, for 3 years on this world, we have a great documentation of him. So I want to take a look at that and look at the baby Jesus through those eyes, through those events. So I want to take a look and imagine growing up with Jesus. Well, as the older brother, because he was the firstborn, so as the older brother, I can see him being protective, but not resorting to violence. He demonstrates this in the later years with the stoning of the prostitute, where he says, "Hey, who's cast the first sin? Or who's without sin cast the first stone?" They all walked away. He solved the issue with no violence. And also when Peter cut off the servant's ear, he said, "Hey, back off," healed the servant. So we know that he was nonviolent, but he was able to solve crisis and issues with that. Both times could have blown up into violent outcomes. But instead, Jesus de-escalates the situation and protects the aggressors from sinning further. "Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." He prevented them from sinning further. That's amazing. Without violence. I remember fighting with my sister and friends. In fact, fighting with my sister sometimes got pretty physical. But what if Jesus was just a stop? Was just there. What if he was there and just stopped me? What if I didn't hit my sister? What if I didn't do these things? What if I didn't yell at my friends? I think Thanksgivings and Christmases and family events would probably be a lot quieter just because Jesus is there. Because he would solve the situations before they began. De-escalate those things. So I kind of see him as being the protector, but the nonviolent protector. Well, as a son, I see him being obedient and honoring his parents. He never talks ill of them, and he even obeys Mary when she asks him to step in and help out in the wedding in Cana. "It's not my time. Okay, Mom, let's do this." And he did it, okay? I think back, what if I had taken out the garbage and not given my parents' attitude? I'm watching a show, being passive-aggressive with them or just talking back. What if I had kept my room clean without my parents demanding me to do it? What if I just did it out of respect for them? Just doing that would have shown them respect and honor. I would have honored my parents. "Honor thy mother and father so that you may live long in the land I show you." Maybe I would have had happier times with them. Maybe I have even more happy memories with them. What if I'd done it? Maybe I would have seen them smile more. Maybe they would have known more that I loved them. As a friend, I see Jesus being mindful. I see him respecting his friends' diversity and helping them grow not only as individuals, but as a group as well. You've got a tax collector. You've got fishermen. You know, you've got people from different walks of life coming and following. You've got a zealot in there. You know, all friends. They hung around with Jesus. They're all focused on him, and they got along. They came to him for guidance, and ultimately, many of them even died for him. Could I have been a better friend simply by trying to help my friends grow as people, as humans, instead of competing with them to show them that I was right, smarter, stronger, or simply the best? What if I had taken my time and energy like Jesus did to help those around him grow closer to God, to grow as human beings? That's my greatest takeaway from Jesus Christ, is that he came to show me how to be a better human and how to grow closer to God and how to reach God. He didn't change himself to gain his friends. And I find myself doing it at times. I think we all do. How much deeper would my friendships be if I had followed his example? I grew up Catholic. In college, I was at, I call them nunneries and monkeries, because, you know, canneries, they can things. Well, it was, in this case, I was at a place that's a monastery, and there's a statue of Mary holding Jesus' limp body there. Being a good child of the Catholic faith, I kneeled before I kneeled before there, and I prayed to Mary. And I asked for her guidance to be a better man and to be a better boyfriend and to be a future husband, to be a better person like that. And I prayed to Jesus then that he would show me how to be a better son and a better friend and a better human. And I also prayed to Joseph, who wasn't there, but I asked him to be a better father. I wanted to be the best father I could be, because I saw in them that through these I could become that. That's what Jesus was teaching me. That's what he's taught me through the Bible. And I didn't see that for so much of my life. That's why I bring this to you now. It's Christmas time. I don't want people to miss what I missed in the Bible. I want people to see these things. I want people to see Jesus and to learn from him. So here at Christmas time, when we gather together around the Nativity, when we're staring at the nativity, that live nativity scene, and we're wondering in our hearts, what child is this? It's already outlined in the Bible what child that is. He is the one who came to teach us to be the better sibling, the better brother or sister, to be the better son, to be the better friend. Maybe for a brief time, we can look past the presents, the holiday decorations, and yes, even the food, and see the people around us. See our friends and family. And let us remember that we can be like Jesus in their lives, helping to bring peace, helping them to grow, and showing them love, and just helping them to grow as people that follow Christ. Be that example that Christ has asked us to be, so that we can all meet again with him in heaven and be with our Father. And maybe, just maybe, we might have more peaceful holidays and more peaceful family life. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, you outlined in the Bible how we need to be, how we need to act as humans to be better humans. You showed us, not by your godhood, but by your manhood, that we could be better, that we could be nicer, that we could be sweeter, that we can be more loving, that we can be more understanding, more accepting, and that we can speak your words and we can bring your love to people, Lord. That we don't have to be afraid because you're there with us. It doesn't matter what others think of us, as long as we are like you, that we are bringing your word, that we can be like you at the stoning of the prostitute, that we can be like you as a brother, as a son, as a friend. So God, through these holidays, let us concentrate on you as a child and what you are going to be, and know that we have that same potential, that we are all the children of the Father, and that we have the potential to be more like you. Amen.
Thank you, Joe, and thank you everyone for tuning into our midweek devotional. If you've been blessed by today's message and you're watching on YouTube, please give us a thumbs up and click the bell to be notified of our future videos. Please join us at our next service. We welcome you and your entire family, and you'll find us right across from Skateland here on Dort Highway each Sunday morning at 10:30. We pray the Lord would bless you so that you then will become a blessing to others.